Welcome to another video in the series on high speed design. I'm Lee Ritchie, Speeding Edge, and what I'm going to do here is show you first why we have differential pairs and how we get from parallel data that is inside a CPU to two wires, a differential pair that goes from one computer to another. The origin of this technology is back in the early days of computing, where we had ECL logic and there were big boxes scattered around the computer room, where the logic ground between them was not good enough for single-ended signaling. So we would convert from parallel data to a serial link to parallel at the other end. And what the benefit was, the circuits that do this can tolerate a large amount of ground offset between the two. And this is the original reason we did it. It is the most robust way there is to connect two circuits together. And you might say, why haven't we done this forever? And the answer is, early on, to get this thing called a SerDes, this serializer deserializer, takes that parallel bus and makes a serial bit stream that kind of looks like that. And sends it down the line. At the other end, we go the other way. We go from a serial stream back to parallel. And that set of circuits was very expensive. So we only did this when we had that ground offset problem that forced us to spend the money on that. Well, when we got to doing wired Ethernet, we would have an Ethernet connection between two different buildings for the same problem. And so we wound up with a serial connection between, and we had a little thing called a modem that did that, did these SerDes things. And of course there was a high price tag. Well, as time has gone by and we have ICs with billions of transistors, we say SerDes are free now. And we kind of think that way now. And so given a choice, we'll always do a serial link as opposed to parallel for a lot of reasons. First of all, it's a lot less wires. Second of all, it's much more tolerant to noise, because if these are side by side and noise comes in from outside, it doesn't degrade the signal. The other thing that we get out of this is, as you know, when we're doing single-ended logic, we have waveforms that look like square waves. And how accurately things operate depends on how sharp that edge is. And if it gets degraded because the path is long and it gets to looking like this, we start to get errors. And the difference is, with differential signaling, we decide when we have a logic state change, when those two cross. So we don't have to worry about how sharp the edges are. So we need only ship to the other end of the line a sine wave that looks like the data to get this to work. So, and that's what's allowed us to drive differential pairs. Right now, we are shipping differential pairs on a board that are running in copper at 56 gigabits per second. If you can imagine that, that is, the clock rate there is 28 gigahertz. Most people would say, well, that's really high-end microwave, but it's digital. It's possible only because we can have differential pairs. So the original reason for doing this was ground offsets. The reason we do it now is we can drive a differential pair at a much, much higher data rate than we can drive a single-ended signal like this one right here. And so every day that we convert a parallel bus to a serial one, we do two things. We save a lot of wires, and we get much more robust link. And I might have said this before, if it weren't for differential pairs, there would be no internet, because we could not run data at the rate we run it with parallel buses. Just can't be done. So everybody who likes the internet, thank differential pairs. So I hope that helps you understand a little bit about what differential pairs are. Maybe I should observe a couple of things. There's only a couple of things that matter in differential pairs. And one is that the two be the same length, with whatever the length tolerance is. And the other is that they not be interfered with by crosstalk from outside. Now, one of the coolest things about differential protocols today is all of the terminators are parallel and they're in the receiver. So the designer only has to lay out two wires and make sure they're the right length, and there's nothing left to do. It's much, much easier to design a board with differential pairs than parallel buses. And the other good news thing is all the protocols now have the clock embedded in the data. So there isn't any need to match a clock with the data in these protocols. Yeah, so I would argue that differential signaling, because of all this, is hard to get it wrong. You really have to work hard to get it wrong. The only way I know to get it wrong is to get these two not the same length and to allow one of them to be interfered with crosstalk from someplace else. Otherwise, all the designers' job have gotten radically easier. Radically easier. I don't know how many designers at Altium are doing this, but everyone I know who has been around conversion from, say, PCI to PCI Express thinks a good thing happened. The example there is PCI Express went from 137 lines to four. Two differential pairs. That's a dramatic change in amount of wire you have to put in the board and things you have to match the length of. So I hope that helps a little bit with why we're using differential pairs. It has made possible things that were not possible before, and I don't know where the limit is. I used to think I did, but at any rate, that's differential signaling.